Geo and Jones in the radio show in the morning. The guy must be a fucking suburbanite white fucking nerd. He believes Josh Gordon. He's like, he's going through mental health problems, this and that. Some people need to cope with it different ways. Don't you understand? Josh Gordon's using a narrative because he's going to get caught smoking weed again because he can't stop because he loves it. That he's using a narrative that it helps his mental health. That's his whole goddamn thing. Don't you understand that? People have mental health all the time. They don't smoke weed. There's nothing wrong with Josh Gordon besides the fact that he's a drug addicted loser who's had not one, not two, not three, but four fucking chances. I don't feel sorry for one bit. In fact, I'm glad. I love the fact that he threw his whole fucking career away over fucking marijuana because he's a fucking retard. He probably hangs around a bunch of people that are fucking morons that just, he's too easily influenced. So it's not because Josh Gordon's having mental problems. They have mental, listen, they have mental illness medications that I've taken before that work. Not marijuana. He's using a narrative, okay, Geo and Jones? Whatever the fuck you... You're like a fucking goddamn suburbanite fucking naive moron. Josh Gordon has failed once again on his teammates. He failed on the Cleveland Browns, and this time he went to the Lee organization. And he couldn't keep it together there. They even had Tom Brady next to him. You would think this guy would learn. He just doesn't get it. His affection for the marijuana is just too strong. So I don't feel sorry for one bit. He'll never play again. Good. Thank God. And I can, quite frankly, if Josh Gordon ends up killing himself or whatever, who gives a flying fuck? The man's had multiple chances. I mean, what the fuck more do you want? Why? This guy's talking about, well, I think NFL's drug policy is too stringent. I agree, but everybody else adheres to it. I mean, out of 1,000 NFL players, 990 people adhere to it. They know what they're doing. So Josh Gordon has no one to blame but himself. Joshua Daniel Gordon, if you have mental health issues, go seek counseling and go get some fucking medication, not marijuana, but you don't have mental health issues. There's nothing wrong with you. You just like marijuana and you can't stop. And it's very hard to get addicted to marijuana. People love marijuana. They're not addicted to it. You just love it. So let's not act like this guy can't stop smoking weed. He's just a dumbass. It's not addicting. At least that's what people told me. So you quit feeling sorry for Josh Gordon if you're out there. I mean, the guy's a loser. I mean, why feel sorry for a guy that's had fucking four chances? 27 years old, what a waste of talent. And I love it. Josh, your move, you fucking loser. Oh, by the way, John Dorsey. John Dorsey owns Bill Belichick. He robbed Bill Belichick of a third-round draft pick for Daniel Shelton, who's a healthy scratch every week for the Patriots. Boy, did he fucking rob William Belichick. And he robbed him of Josh Gordon. Traded a seventh-round pick and Josh Gordon for a fifth-round pick. So, John Dorsey, you're a fucking biblical beast. Danny Shelton, healthy scratch every week. We get a third-round pick. You know what a third-round pick is in NFL? That's huge. And a fifth-round or two? When you pick players such as Jonathan G.L. Dorsey. Fifth round pick is beautiful. So, Josh, thank you for tripping up again, you fucking loser. What's up, bro? Hey, is Josh Gordon a loser? Yes or no? Thank you. See? Albert the Cat says Josh Gordon's a fucking loser. Right? Hey. Fucking beast. I know he's a loser. It's a fucking disgrace. I know he's a fucking dumbass. If you had a chance to make that money, he just said if he had a chance to make that money, he would do it. He just said he quit doing catnip for that kind of money. Josh Gordon can't get off the weed.